Welcome to Signal and System lecture series. Here in this session, I'll be explaining classifications of signal. So to explain this, there are different categories of classification of signal that I have listed here. One by one, I'll explain meaning of all those classification of signals. So first classification, that one can have it based on continuous time signal and discrete time signal. Now see, in continuous time signal, we'll be having continuous information of any physical quantity which may be varying with respect to time, right? So here I have listed even that is what continuous time means. It is varying with respect to time, which is continuous one. Like see, if I draw a random data here. So if I say this is what x of t, where this signal is varying with respect to time. So this is what continuous time signal, where you'll be finding signal is continuous. So infinite points are there with this graph. So when you want to store this continuous time signal, you need to have infinite memory. So continuous time signal that requires infinite memory, and for a processing, infinite memory may create some problems. So in digital systems, usually we translate continuous time signals into discrete time signals. So what is discrete time signal? So here I'll mention this. Like see, if you make it to discrete time, in that case, what we will be doing is we'll be taking some intervals only. We will not take all points. So discrete time, that we denote it as x of n, where we will be taking samples. So if I take samples after this interval, one can see here I have mentioned it by 1, 2, 3, 4, right? And shape of signal is same. Like one can see with continuous time, I have made it. So just that is what the case which I am taking here. So see, at this interval, amplitude is this much. For interval 1, amplitude is this much. So these are the data that we will be taking for discrete. Right, we will not take all points. We will be taking just a sample at few interval. So this is what discrete time signal, right? So here amplitude is continuous, but time is different, discrete. So this is what discrete time signals, where now you'll be finding you don't need to take all samples. You will be taking samples after fixed interval. So if I take time period, and that time period is TS, so sampling frequency for that is FS, which will be 1 by TS. So as per this sampling frequency, we'll be considering time and we'll be taking information. So this is about continuous time and discrete time signals. Now let us discuss deterministic and random signals. So deterministic means we can define that with function. So deterministic signal, that is what we can define it by function. We can predict that data of signal. While random signal, that is not deterministic. We cannot define it by function. It is random in nature. So it is next to impossible to predict that data. So deterministic is like we can define it, we can make it with some formulas, we can predict those data of signal. But random signal, that is unpredictable, like speech signal, that is random signal, right? So this is how one can understand. Deterministic means we can define it by function. Random means it is not defined by function, it is random in nature. Now next category, that is even and odd signals. Now see, what is even and odd signal? Even signal, if I say, I just want to mention even signal, right? So even signal is having characteristic, that is x of n, that will be equal to x of minus n. So this is what even signal. And as if you say x of n, that is equals to minus of x of minus n. So this is odd signal. In detail, I'll explain all those things, but right now you just consider even signal. That is what x of n is equals to x of minus n. Even signal means even one can say it is symmetric signal. And odd signal, that is asymmetric signal. So for asymmetric means odd signal, x of n is equals to minus of x of minus n. And for even signal, it will be x of n is equals to x of minus n. So that is how even an odd signal is defined. Now see, periodic and aperiodic signal. So periodic means a signal which is repeating after fixed interval. So if signal is getting repeated after finite duration, that is periodic signal. And aperiodic signal means a signal which is not getting repeated after finite duration. So that is aperiodic signal. So we have seen sine waves. So that is what getting repeated after fixed interval, that is periodic signal. Aperiodic signal does not get repeated after fixed time interval, so it is what? Aperiodic signal. So based on repetition, we can justify whether given signal is periodic or aperiodic. So periodic signal, that is getting repeated after finite duration. Aperiodic signal, that is not getting repeated after finite duration. Now see, energy and power signal. So when we talk about energy and power signal, energy signal, that is having finite energy, and power signal, that is having finite power. So let us try to understand that. See, energy signal is having finite energy, and power signal, that is having finite power. And to understand that, let me go to next blank page. See, if energy is finite, then signal is energy signal. And if signal is energy signal, in that case, power will be zero. And if signal is power signal, if signal is power signal, then power will be finite. And if power is finite, energy will be infinite. Now see how to calculate energy. So when you calculate energy, so to have a calculation of energy, basic formula is energy is equals to limit t tends to infinite integration from minus t by 2 to t by 2 x square t dt, where xt is signal. So energy is finite, that is what energy signal, and we can calculate energy by this. If you calculate energy and if it is infinite, then that is not energy signal. So we need to calculate energy by this formula, and it should be finite. If it is finite, it is energy signal, and you will be finding power of that is zero. And to get power of given signal, we need to use this formula, power, where limit t tends to infinite 1 by t integration minus t by 2 to t by 2 x square t dt. So when you calculate power, if it is finite by this formula, then it is power signal, and you will be finding energy for power signal will be infinite. In detail, I'll explain session based on energy and power, but here this is just a basic of energy signal and power signal. I hope that you have understood this. Now see, one more category, that is real signal and imaginary signal. So what is real signal? Real signal means data is real. There is no imaginary component. There is no complex data. And in imaginary signals, you will be finding complex data is there. So in future, when I'll make videos based on this topic, you'll be getting how we can justify given signal is real and imaginary. So I think basic mathematics that you have done till today's engineering life. So I hope that you get to know like what is real and what is imaginary. But still, we'll solve some examples so it will be more clear. So thank you so much for watching this video. I hope that you have understood this classification of signals. This is so essential. In future, I'll make videos based on examples of all those classification, and in detail we will study all those topic so it will be more clear to all of you. Thank you so much for watching this video. You can give your valuable suggestions. Definitely based on your suggestions, in future I'll make videos which will gives you better understanding. So please give your suggestions. Thank you so much for watching this video.